गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतान शृण्वन्नोतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात्परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ओम्। डियर् फ्रेण्ड्स्, वी आर् इन् दिस् विवेकचूडामणि। इन् द लास्ट् क्लास् वि रेड् श्लोका नम्बर् 225 as per this Ramakrishna Mission edition, 227 according to that Shrungeri edition, that is Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma Vishuddham Param Swatas Siddham, that particular shloka we read and I explained that shloka. So now, after say dismissing all the pancha koshas as not the Atman, Shankaracharya is now talking about what exactly is the Atman. Because in the meantime, after denying or after negating all the five koshas, the Shishya raised a doubt. If you are negating everything, what remains is only Shunya. What remains is only an Abhava. Then the teacher started saying, it is not Abhava. That is, there is a knower for that Abhava also. If you are saying that there is an Abhava, there is somebody who is perceiving that Abhava. And that knower of Abhava is always existing, that always exists, and that particular consciousness, that particular say sat and chit, so that is what is Brahma. Satyam jnanam anantam Brahma, this particular line is from, we know that it is from the Taittiriya Upanishad, and then Shankaracharya, we know that he has given a very elaborate say commentary on that, running into a few pages, and then in fact we took about 10 days to say study all that. So this particular reply the teacher gives, and he is going on to explain that apart from Brahman there is nothing else, because in that Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma also towards the end Shankaracharya points out that the so-called Srushti Shruti means the Shrutis, or rather the scriptural sentences which talk about the so-called Srushti or the evolution as such. The purpose is not to explain the sequence of evolution. The purpose is not to explain from A, B has come, from B, C has come. It is not that. It is only to explain that ultimately that particular one, that Mola Karanam, that Brahman alone exists, and all this thing is only a manifestation in that Brahma. So the purpose of all these Srushti Shrutis is only to say that nothing exists apart from Brahma. So that is what is Shankaracharya going to say here also. So the next shloka, that is 226, sadidam paramadvaitam swasmadanyasya vastuna bhavat nakhyanyadasti kinchit samyak paratattva bodha sudashayam. Sadidam paramadvaitam, sadidam, that is idam brahma, idam, we are now talking about Brahma. So which means that idam brahma sat, that is something which is non-negatable, that is something which cannot be dismissed, it is always there, it is beyond the three time, trikala badhyam, it is beyond time. So idam brahma sat, then what else? Parama advaitam, it is totally apart from that, nothing else exists, because that is something which is of the nature of infinity, and apart from infinity nothing else exists. And there is no identification, in fact in that Brahman, there is no identification with any sort of guna, with any sort of sharira, or any such thing. There is no identification, there is no differentiation. It is pure sat and pure chit where there is no differentiation. So that is that paramadvaitam. Then swasmadanyasya vastunaha abhavat. Because apart from Brahman, there is no possibility of another vastu. Because Brahman itself is of the nature of Ananta, of the nature of infinity, and apart from infinity, there is no possibility for any vastu to exist apart from that. Then, na hyanyadasti kinchit samyak paramartha tattva bodha dashayam. For a seeker who has reached that level of understanding, paratattva bodha sudashayam. Paratattva means the nature of that Supreme Self. Para is Supreme, Tattva is that nature, the reality. Bodha is understanding. Sudashayam, in that high state of understanding the real nature of the Supreme Reality. In that state, where one has understood the nature of that supreme reality, then he realizes that he is only the so-called ego. Once the ego disappears, he realizes he is of the nature of that Sat and Chit. We know that famous shloka, Sat, Chit and Ananda, these three are, the three are Brahma Rupam, Nama Rupam, say, Tato, Tato, what is this, what is that shloka? Asti Bhati Priyam Rupam Namachet Yamsha Panchakam, isn't it? Asti Bhati Priyam. Asti is the Sat, element of existence. Asti, Asti means exists. Sat. Bhati, Bhati means that is Chit. That is, it shines, it illumines, it means it, it is of the nature of, say, Chit. Asti Bhati Priyam. Priyam means Ananda. Then Rupam Namacha Ityamsha Panchakam. Adhyatrayam Brahma Rupam. The first three, they are, they characterize Brahma. Then what else? Jagat, Tatonya, what is this? What is that? Adhyatrayam Brahma Rupam. Then the next two, the later two, that is Rup, that is Nama and Rupa, they denote this whole Jagat. That is what the shloka says. So that is how he says, in that particular state of highest awareness, then, and the commentator, of course, Chandrasekhara Bharati, he also quotes that Shruti lines, Nanyat Pashyati, Nanyat Shrunoti, Nanyat Jigrati, etc., etc. That is, at that stage, he does not see any duality. A person, a realized person, does not see duality. Nanyat Pashyati, he sees everything as Brahman. Nanyat Shrunoti, whatever he hears it as Brahman. So, that is that stage of realization. And for such a person, there is no duality. So, which means that in reality, there is no such thing as duality. Then the same thing carries the entire sequence of, say, shlokas today. We will read some similar, shlokas. Next shloka is, Yadidam sakalam vishvam nana rupam pratitam ajnanat tat sarvam brahmaiva pratyastashesha bhavana dosham. Yadidam sakalam vishvam nana rupam. So this vishvam, vishvam is this universe. Idam vishvam, this particular universe. Which means whenever you say idam, idam means you are objectifying it. You are the knower and this vishvam is something which is known. That is drushyam and druk, kshetra, kshetrajna. So those names we come across very frequently. So idam, whenever we say idam, idam means that means you are objectifying it. Idam sakalam vishvam. Nana Rupam, it is having all shapes and forms, that is names and forms. Then Kalpitam, Pratitam Ajnanat. Pratitam is, that is something which is Kalpitam, which is just visualized, Ajnanat. Ajnanat Kalpitam. Then Ajnana is the inability to understand or lack of understanding of the truth. That is what is Ajnana. Ajnana is one thing and Moha or Brahma is slightly different. Ajnana is not knowing a thing as it is, that is Ajnana. Knowing it as something else is Moha or Brahma. Not knowing the rope is Ajnana. Knowing the rope as a snake is Brahma or Moha. So, a slight difference. So, Nana Rupam Pratitam Ajnanat Tat Sarvam Brahmaiva. All that what we observe as names and forms, if you divest them of all the names and forms, it is of the nature of Sat and Chit and Ananda. Sat, Chit, Ananda only, that is what exists. And then all these names and forms, they are only appearances in that, in those three components. Pratyastha, Ashesha, Bhavana, Dosham. Dosham, this is basically because of some faulty perception, faulty understanding. Bhavana, Dosham. That is, Bhavana, Dosham means what? Wrong perception. Dosham means wrong, fault. Bhavana dosham means, bhavana is visualization, your understanding, a fault in understanding. So, tatsarvam brahmaiva pratyastha ashesha bhavana dosham. Then when does it become Brahma? All what all we see, when does it become Brahma? When all our defective vision disappears. The whole world appears as Brahma. When? Only when our defective vision disappears. So, that is what he says, pratyastha. Pratyastha means, the state of getting rejected. Pratyastha is negated, rejected. Pratyastha, ashesha. Ashesha means that innumerable, endless. So many defects are there in our perception. when all those defects in our understanding are negated, that is what it means. Pratyastha ashesha bhavana dosham means when all these defective perceptions or understandings are negated. Timira drushti is negated. Yeah, timira drushti is negated and samyak drushti comes. So that is it. So tatsarvam brahmaiva pratyastashesha bhavana dosham. So the total sentence will mean Brahman in which all these defective visions have been eliminated. All these aspects of defective vision, all these results of all these visualizations due to defective understanding, they have all been negated. So then the entire Vishwam will be seen as Brahma alone. Then he also says, he gives the other logic. That is, we have seen that Chandogya Upanishad says one thing. That is, Vacharambhanam Vikaro Namadheyam Ruttiketyeva Satyam. That Shvetaketu goes to his father, and that father, he says, Tattvamasi Shvetaketu, etc., etc. And then he says, Vacharambhanam Vikaro Namadheyam. It is a very famous line. That is, he gives the example of Mrut and various parts. He gives the example of gold and various ornaments. So if you take the most common example of the clay and so many varieties of pots, so all these pots, they are but names and forms, whereas the essence is that mrut. So similarly, what all we see as jagat is something which is only names and forms, but the reality is that supreme reality, that is that Brahman. So that is what he is going to say. Mrutkarya bhutopi mrudona bhinnaha mrudona bhinnah kumbhosti सर्वत्र तु मृत्स्वरूपात् न कुंभरूपं पृथगस्ति कुंभः कुतो मृषा कल्पितनाम मात्रः. सो दट इज मृत्कार्यभूतोपि मृदो न भिन्नः. दिस मृत्कार्यभूतः दट इज घटः मृत्कार्यभूतः मीन्स दट इज घट इज ओनली एन इफेक्ट ऑफ मृत्कार्यभूतः मीन्स इट इज ए कार्यभूत इज it is a karya. Apart from that, there is no meaning. Karya bhutopi, though it is mrut karyam, mrudona bhinnaha, it is not apart from mrut. Mrudaha na bhinnaha, mrudaha, mrudaha na bhinnaha. Mrudaha is in panchami vibhakti. Mrut is the word, mrudaha is panchami vibhakti. Mrudona bhinnaha, it is not different from the mrut. It is mrut karyam, no doubt, but it is not different from mrut, because all through its body, anywhere you touch at the top, you touch at the bottom, you touch anywhere in the middle, you touch every bit of it is mrut only. So na bhinnaha kumbhosti, that is kumbhaha bhinnaha nasti. Anvaya is kumbhaha mrudaha bhinnaha nasti. Kumbha is not apart from mrut. Then sarvatra tu mrut swarupat, sarvatra, all over, wherever you touch the neck, you touch the rim, you touch anywhere, it is all mrut only. Sarvatra tu mrut swarupat, mrut swarupa. Rupam is different from swarupam, isn't it? A pot or a plate, that is rupam. Swarupa is mrut. Rupam may be some chain, it may be a ring, it may be some other bracelet, that is rupam. But swarupam is gold. So like that, rupa is different from swarupa. So, but then the essential nature, the swarupa doesn't change. Rupa may change. There may be thousands and thousands of rupas, but then swarupa does not change. Then na kumbharupam prutagasti kumbhakuto murshakalpitanama matra. Kumbharupam na prutagasti. There is no such thing as separate, which can be distinguished from say clay. There is no such thing as a part which can be totally distinguished or separated from the clay. Then kumbhakutaha murshakalpitanama matra. This is something which is mursha. Mursha means something which is unreal. Mrusha kalpita nama matra. This is something which is just visualized. It is only a name and form. Mrusha kalpitam. That is something which has been visualized, which has been seen or created as a name, separate name and form. But kumbha kutaha. In reality, where is that kumbha? Kutaha. Kumbha kutaha. The question. Where in reality is that kumbha? It means kumbha doesn't exist apart from the clay. So that Vacharambhana Vikaro Namadheyam is the Vacharambhana Vikaro Namadheyam is the Shruti which is quoted by Swamiji, Chandrasekhara Bharati Swamiji. Then K केनापि मृद्भिन्नतया स्वरूपं घटस्य संदर्शयितुं न शक्यते। अतो घटः कल्पित एव मोहात् मृदैव सत्यं परमार्थभूतम्। सेम पॉइंट ही सेइंग दैट इज मृत्तिकेत्येव सत्यम्। मृत्तिका अलोन इज द सत्, दैट इज द रियल। ऑल अदर थिंग्स आर नामधेयम्, दैट इज ध्येय मात्रार्थे ध्येय प्रत्ययः। वी हैव सीन वाइल एक्सप्लेनिंग दैट लाइन, दैट इज नाम मात्रम्। दे आर मियर नेम्स, दे आर मियर, एंड इट इज ओनली अ वाचारंभणम्। इट इज अ वर्बल से एक्सप्रेशन, दैट्स ऑल। ए पॉट, अनदर थिंग कॉल्ड ए जार और सम अदर टम्बलर, ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर मियर नेम्स, वाचारंभणम्, ए वर्बल एक्सप्रेशंस एंड नेम अलो, मियर नेम्स। बट द ट्रूथ इज दैट इट इज ऑल क्लेम। सो केनापि मृद्भिन्नतया स्वरूपं घटस्य संदर्शयितुं न शक्यते। मृद्भिन्नतया तस्य स्वरूपं न संदर्शयितुं शक्यते। अपार्ट फ्रॉम मृत्, मृद्भिन्नतया मीन्स अपार्ट फ्रॉम मृत्, से तस्य स्वरूपं, द रियल नेचर, स्वरूपं, द वेरी एसेंस ऑफ दट घट, इट कैनॉट बी शोन एज समथिंग विच इज अपार्ट फ्रॉम दट मृत्। देन अतः देयरफॉर घटः कल्पित एव मोहात्, इट इज समथिंग विच इज विजुअलाइज्ड बिकॉज ऑफ अवर रॉन्ग परसेप्शन। मृदेव सत्यम परमार्थभूतम्, दिस मृत अलोन इज सत्यम, दट इज द वेरी एसेंस। सो हियर ऑफ कोर्स वी हैव टू सी दट इट शुड नॉट बी मिस्टेकन एज सम सॉर्ट ऑफ ब्रह्म परिणामवाद। अगेन ब्रह्म इज चेंजिंग इन टू ऑल दीज थिंग्स, मृत एंड ऑर्नमेंट्स, सॉरी गोल्ड एंड ऑर्नमेंट्स आर मृत, क्ले एंड पॉट्स, दे हैव बीन गिवन एज एग्जाम्पल्स ओनली टू मेक अस अंडरस्टैंड। But Brahma is not changing. Here, of course, Mruti is changing, undergoing some change. It is something which is physical thing, which we are seeing. But Brahman is not changing. Brahma, it is not Brahma Parinamavada. It is only Brahma Vivartavada. Brahman is appearing as all this, which we are going to see. Brahma Parinamavada is also accepted by some people. I have not read Ramanuja, but then scholars point out that Ramanuja's theory is Brahma Parinamavada. Prakriti Parinamavada is that of Sankhyas. We know that there is what is called Satkaryavadam. Before Satkaryavadam, the basic point is about the theory of causation. There are various theories of causation. That is, we are seeing the world around us. For this whole world around us, what is the cause? So that is when you speculate on that, it is called the theory of causation. Then Buddhists say that there is absolutely nothing, shunya, and from that shunya, all these things has come into existence. So that is what they say. And then, of course, they have developed their own logic for that. And then, this Satkaryavada is of the Sankhyas. That is, Karyam is always embedded or already, it is, Karyam pre-exists in the Karanam. Karyam, it pre-exists in the Karanam. It is there, always in the Karana. That is what they say. So that means, when you are seeing the whole Jagat, it is there in the Karana. It is not something which is newly come. It is always there. It has just come, of course. It has come, of course. But then it is not something which is totally not there earlier. It is always there. So this Karyam has always been there. So that is what is called Sat Karyavada. Karyam is Sat. Nayayikas also, they say that it is Sat Karyavada. That is because the Jagat is Sat for them. Then Sankhyas, the difference is Prakriti Parinamavada. Their point is Prakriti Parinamavadinaha. They accept two principles, that is what is called Prakriti and a Purusha. Purusha is the sentient entity and Prakriti is the insentient entity. And in that Prakriti, of course, their basic contribution, their wonderful contribution is that of the three gunas. This wonderful contribution of three gunas have been accepted by sage Vyasa into Brahma Sutras. And these gunas are also mentioned in our Upanishads. So that way they have been integrated. Kapila has to some extent been integrated into Vedanta. But then the basic difference exists. That is, when it comes to basics, they are dualists. That is Prakriti and Purusha. So their theory is that is Prakriti Parinamavada. And then the Brahma Parinamavada is that of Ramanuja. Then what does Vedanta say? Shankara Vedanta or Advaita Vedanta? Advaita Vedanta, that non-dual Vedanta says, is that Brahman is appearing as this whole universe. This is a manifestation. Because, and when we say manifestation, you are not totally denying its existence. ఇట్ ఈస్ అపియరింగ్ అండ్ సచ్చేతన బాధ్యత అసచ్చేతన నివర్తేత దట్ ఈస్ వన్ ప్రిన్సిపల్ దట్ ఈస్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ వర్ టు బి అబ్సల్యూట్లీ సత్ దెన్ ఇట్ వుడ్ నాట్ బి నెగేటెడ్ బట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ గెటింగ్ నెగేటెడ్ ఇన్ ది సెన్స్ దట్ వెన్ ఎ పర్సన్ రియలైజెస్ ది సుప్రీం రియాలిటీ దిస్ వరల్డ్ ఈస్ నెగేటెడ్ అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ సీన్ యాజ్ బ్రహ్మ అండ్ అసత్ చేత్ న నివర్తేత ఇఫ్ ఇట్ వర్ టు బి టోటలీ అసత్ సచ్చేతన బాధ్యత యా ఇఫ్ ఇట్ వర్ టు బి టోటలీ అన్రియల్ దెన్ ఇట్ విల్ నాట్ అసలు ఇట్ విల్ నాట్ ఈవెన్ అపియర్ సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ ది పాయింట్ అసచ్చేత్ న ప్రతీయేత నా నివర్తేత నాట్ ది నివర్తేత అసచ్చేత్ న ప్రతీయేత ఇఫ్ ఇట్ వర్ టు బి టోటలీ అసత్ ఇట్ వుడ్ నాట్ బి సీన్ సో దట్ ఈస్ ది డైలమా సో దట్ ఈస్ వై వీ సే సద్ అసద్భ్యాం అనిర్వచనీయం దిస్ జగత్ ఈస్ సంథింగ్ వెన్ వీ కాల్ మాయా ఆర్ మిథ్యా వీ డోంట్ సే దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ టోటలీ అన్రియల్ లైక్ ది సన్ ఆఫ్ ఎ బ్యారన్ ఉమన్ ఆర్ సమ్ ఖపుష్పం దట్ ఎ ఫ్లవర్ ఇన్ ది స్కై బట్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ గాట్ సమ్ సార్ట్ ఆఫ్ టెంటేటివ్ ఎగ్జిస్టెన్స్ సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ వీ సే సో దిస్ పర్టిక్యులర్ శ్లోక షుడ్ నాట్ బి మిస్అండర్స్టూడ్ యాజ్ బ్రహ్మ పరిణామవాద అఫ్ కోర్స్ నెక్స్ట్ శ్లోక ఆల్సో ఇట్ ఈస్ కంటిన్యూయింగ్ లైక్ దట్ ఓన్లీ సద్బ్రహ్మకార్యం సకలం సదేవం తన్మాత్రమేతం న తతోన్యదస్తి అస్తీతి యో వక్తి న తస్య మోహో వినిర్గతో నిద్రితవత్ ప్రజల్పః సద్బ్రహ్మకార్యం సకలం సద్ ఏవం తన్మాత్రమేతత్ దెన్ దిస్ వాట్ ఆల్ వి సీ ఈస్ ఇట్ ఇస్ సత్ బ్రహ్మ కార్యం దిస్ ఈస్ సంథింగ్ విచ్ హ్యాస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అ మేనిఫెస్టేషన్ ఇన్ దట్ బ్రహ్మ ఇట్ ఈస్ అ కార్యం నో డౌట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అ కార్యం బట్ వాట్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ కార్యం వెదర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అ రియల్ కార్యం ఆర్ అన్రియల్ కార్యం ఇట్ ఈస్ సంథింగ్ సదసద్భ్యాం అనిర్వచనీయం అండ్ దట్ ఈస్ ద కారణం ఈజ్ అఫ్ కోర్స్ దట్ సద్ బ్రహ్మ కారణం అఫ్ కోర్స్ ఈజ్ సత్ కారణం ఈజ్ సత్ బట్ ది కార్యం ఈజ్ సదసద్భ్యాం అనిర్వచనీయం సద్ బ్రహ్మ కార్యం సో దట్ ఈస్ ప్యూర్లీ వాట్ వీ సీ ఇన్ ఉపనిషత్స్ ఆల్సో దట్ ఈస్ దిస్ సత్ అండ్ చిత్ కాన్షియస్నెస్ అండ్ ఎగ్జిస్టెన్స్ అపియరింగ్ యాజ్ దిస్ యూనివర్స్ మేనిఫెస్టేషన్ అపియర్ మేనిఫెస్టింగ్ యాజ్ దిస్ హోల్ యూనివర్స్ కాన్షియస్నెస్ అపియరింగ్ యాజ్ దిస్ హోల్ యూనివర్స్ సో సద్ బ్రహ్మ కార్యం సకలం సత్ ఏవం అఫ్ కోర్స్ ద అదర్ యువర్ బుక్స్ ఏస్ సదైవం సంథింగ్ లైక్ దట్ సదా ఏవం సదా ఏవం డజంట్ మ్యాటర్ సత్ ఏవం తన్మాత్రమేతత్ దట్ అలోన్ తన్మాత్ర వెన్ వీ సే తన్మాత్ర తత్ మాత్ర దట్ ఈస్ దట్ అలోన్ దట్ మీన్స్ దట్ బ్రహ్మన్ అలోన్ అండ్ నథింగ్ ఎల్స్ దెన్ దట్ తన్మాత్రమేతత్ నా తతోన్యదస్తి అపార్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ దట్ సత్య అపార్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ దట్ బ్రహ్మన్ అన్యత్ డస్ నాట్ ఎగ్జిస్ట్ దెన్ అస్తీతి యో వక్తి న తస్య మోహో వినిర్గత వెన్ సంబడీ సేస్ ఎస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎగ్జిస్టింగ్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ ఎ సెపరేట్ ఎగ్జిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్స్ ఓన్ వెన్ సంబడీ సేస్ లైక్ దట్ తస్య మోహ న వినిర్గత హిస్ డెల్యూజన్ హ్యాస్ నాట్ గాన్ దట్ మీన్స్ హీ ఈస్ స్టిల్ అండర్ ద డెల్యూజన్ దట్ దెర్ ఈస్ సంథింగ్ విచ్ ఈస్ ఎ డ్యుయాలిటీ దిస్ బ్రహ్మన్ ఆల్సో ఎగ్జిస్ట్ అండ్ దట్ ఆల్సో ఎగ్జిస్ట్ వెన్ వీ సే దట్ బ్రహ్మన్ ఆల్సో ఎగ్జిస్ట్ అండ్ జగత్ ఆల్సో ఎగ్జిస్ట్ దెన్ దే ఆర్ టూ మ్యూచువలీ ఎగ్జిస్టింగ్ మ్యూచువలీ ఎక్స్క్లూజివ్ థింగ్స్ ఇఫ్ ఐ అండ్ యూ బోత్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఓకే ఐ ఆమ్ సెపరేట్ అండ్ యూ ఆర్ సెపరేట్ అండ్ వీఆర్ మ్యూచువలీ ఎక్స్క్లూజివ్ ఐ కాంట్ బి యూ అండ్ యూ కాంట్ బి మీ సో వీఆర్ మ్యూచువలీ ఎక్స్క్లూజివ్ బోత్ ఆర్ సెపరేట్ దెన్ బ్రహ్మ విల్ బి సంథింగ్ విచ్ ఈస్ ఎ పరిచ్ఛిన్న సో దట్ విల్ బి ద పాయింట్ సో అస్తీతి యో వక్తి ఎ పర్సన్ హూ సేస్ ఎస్ దెర్ ఈస్ సంథింగ్ దిస్ జగత్ ఈస్ టోటలీ రియల్ టెంటేటివ్ రియాలిటీ వీఆర్ నాట్ డినైయింగ్ టెంటేటివ్ రియాలిటీ వీఆర్ యాక్సెప్టింగ్ వెన్ వీ సే వెన్ హీ సేస్ దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎగ్జిస్టింగ్ అబ్సల్యూట్లీ దెన్ తస్య మోహ నవినిర్గత హీ దట్ ఈస్ హీస్ డెల్యూజన్ His delusion caused by ignorance, it is something which has not gone. Nidritavat prajalpaha. So just like a person who is in dream, he is blabbering something. A person in dream, okay, means some dream he sees in sleep. He has got a nice dream or whatever dream. And then he blabbers something. So like that blabber of a person in sleep, it is like that. So that is what he says. So here again, for this shloka also, we can understand it in the light of that Satkaryavadam, Asatkaryavadam, etc. Because this Brahman alone is Sat, and this Sakalam Sadevam Tanmatram Etat. Tanmatram is that alone, and apart from that, the reality, the Swarupa is the same. Then again the same thing. బ్రహ్మై వేదం విశ్వమిత్యేవ వాణి శ్రౌతి బ్రూతే అథర్వ నిష్ఠావరిష్ట తస్మాదేతద్ బ్రహ్మమాత్రం హి విశ్వం నాధిష్టానాద్ భిన్నతారోపితస్య Then he says, Brahmai Vedam Vishwamidam Varishtam. That line is there in Mundakopanishad. He is referring to that Mundakopanishad. Mundakopanishad, we know that it is from Atharva Veda. This Mundakopanishad and also Prashnopanishad. These two are related to Atharva Veda, isn't it? So, Brahmai Vedam Vishwam, that means this Idam Vishwam, whatever we are objectifying as Vishwam, is Brahmaiva. So, there we have seen Mundakopanishad, that second Mundaka we have seen. Brahmai Vedam Vishwam. Ityeva Vani, that is the Vani, that is what is the pronouncement, let us say, that is the pronouncement of Shruti, Shrauti Vani. Shrauti Vani, that is Shrauti is the adjective for Vani, that is the voice of the scripture. Shrauti Vani is the voice of the scripture. Shrauti Brute, that says, the voice of the scripture says that. Atharvanishtha Varishtha, Varishtha means something which is great. Atharva Nishtha, that which is there contained in that Atharva Veda. Then Tasmat, therefore, Etat Brahma Matram Hi Vishwam. So he is quoting various reasons, Shruti, Yukti, Anubhava, etc., etc. Tasmat, Etat Brahma Matram Hi Vishwam. This Vishwam is nothing apart from Brahma. Na Adhishthanat Bhinnata Aropitasya. There is what is called Adhishthanam, there is what is called Aropanam. Adhishthanam means the base, the support, the substratum, the rope. The most common example is the rope and the snake. So, rope is the basis for all types of visualization. Rope, seeing a rope somewhere in, say, semi-dark situation, it can be mistaken as a garland, it can be mistaken as a bhuchidra, that is a small crack in the earth, it can be mistaken for a jaladhara, some water, say, water which has fallen there, or it can be mistaken for a snake. Depending on one's own samskara, you visualize anything you want. So, na adhisthanat bhinnata aropitasya. This aropitam is something which is totally different. This aropitam can be anything. One man will think it as a garland, another man will think it as something else, etc., etc. But then adhisthanam doesn't change. Adhisthanat bhinnata aropitasya. Na adhisthanat bhinnata. That is aropitasya vastunaha for something which has been superimposed. Aropitam is something which is being superimposed. It cannot be something which is apart from what is there as Adhishthanam. Adhishthanam is the only thing that is the reality. Aropitam is something which you are visualizing on that. Then, the next shloka also, he is giving certain reasons. He is giving certain reasons why, say, this Aropana is something which cannot be true. This Aropana or superimposition or this false understanding, it cannot be true. So, he is giving certain reasons. Satyam yadisya jagadeta datmano jagadeta datmano anantatvaha nirnigama pramanata asatyavaditvam apishu tusyat naitatrayam sadhu hitam mahatmanam. He is giving four reasons here. Satyam yadisya jagadetat atmanaha anny atmanaha jagadetat atmanaha anantatva hanihi. So the anvaya is like that. Satyam yadi syat jagat. Yadi jagat satyam syat. If this world were to be true. Satyam jagat yadi satyam syat. If the world were to be true, then atmanaha anantatva hanihi. That is, you are negating. Hani. Hani means that is negating. You are negating the infinite nature of that Atma. Atma is infinite, we know. And if you say that Jagat also exists and that also exists, so X and Y do not exist in the same place, isn't it? You and I cannot exist, of course, in a room it is okay. But then in a room also we exist as separate people. But in the same chair, in the same place, you can't exist. In that same chair, I cannot exist. So two things cannot exist in the same place if both are real, if both are to be real. If one is real and if one is, another is unreal, then they can exist. That is, sarpa is real, not snake, sorry, rope is real, and the sarpa is unreal. Such things can exist. But if you say that both are real, they can't exist. And then when you say that they are existing, then naturally they are mutually exclusive. Anyonya bhava is also there, isn't it? Anyonya, X is not Y and Y is not X. So when that is so, then Brahma becomes delimited by Jagat. Brahma becomes somebody who is delimited by this Jagat. So that is it. Atmano anantatva hanihi. So this is point number one. if you say that the jagat also exists, then you are negating the anantatva of Brahman. Then nigama apramanata, number two, nigama apramanata. Nigama is what? Veda. Nigama is Veda. Nigama, agama, sometimes depending on these words, depending on the context, we take the words. Nigama apramanata, that is, there are so many lines in Upanishads which say satyam jnanam anantam brahma, etc., etc. The anantatva of Brahman is told in so many places, isn't it? The infinite, the nature, the Brahman as infinity is shown in so many places. So they become apramanam. Apramanam is something which is not valid. It is, Shruti is making an invalid or false statement. So that is what it means. Then asatyavaditvam api ishituhu syat. Ishita. Ishita means what? Ishita means the ruler. Ishana shilaha. Ishita. Asatyavaditvam api ishituhu syat. Ishita. For ishita, ishituhu is shashti ekavachanam. Ishituhu. Asatyavaditvam api syat. That is, you are attributing, or rather you will be attributing asatyavaditvam to the Lord, because the Lord always says that Brahman is something which is of the nature of infinite. Then if you say that in Brahman is not infinite, not only is Shruti is a pramanam, you are also saying that Lord Krishna or whoever it is in Bhagavad Gita or in some other place or in some other place, you are accusing him of telling some falsehood. That is asatyavaditvam. Then not only that, then it is also against the experience of this sadhus. Mahatmanam naitatrayam sadhu hitam mahatmanam. You see, mahatmas who have realized the nature of Brahman, they have realized it is not as though something which is only a sort of cock and bull story or something which the Shruti is making a false statement. It is not like that. Because a Mahatma or a realized person, by virtue of the teaching from a Guru, Shastra, Acharya, Upadesha Vashat, that is, Shastra is there, Acharya is there, and then his own sadhana is there. Shastra, Acharya, Upadesha itself is not enough. His own internal, say, quest has to be there. So his own effort, that purifying, self-purification, all that has to go on. So such people, they have realized Brahma. And then if you say that Jagat is also existing, that goes against the experience or the anubhava, that goes against the anubhava of the realized persons. So this, the fourth point is, naitat trayam, the above three, etat trayam, the above three, sadhu hitam na mahatmanam. This na has to be applied to this. Na sadhu hitam mahatmanam. It is something which cannot be accepted by the Mahatmas, because the Mahatmas who have realized Brahman, they see Jagat as unreal. And if you say that Jagat is real, you are going against the experience of some of the people who are wise. So that is what is the point. Is it clear? Then the next line also is shloka is also like that. Ishvaro vastu tatvajnyo. Here we are referring to Gita. 9th chapter of Gita, we have come across two wonderful shlokas. That is, matstani sarvabhutani, nachamastani bhutani, etc., etc. That Chandrasekhara Bharati Swami, he explains those shlokas. That is, that shloka number 4, 9th chapter, shloka 4. Maya tatamidam sarvam jagadavyaktamurtina matsthani sarvabhutani nachaham teshvavasthitaha. So that is the shloka, isn't it? Maya tatamidam sarvam. That is, everything else, everything here, idam sarvam, all this is something which is pervaded by me. That is, the snake is totally pervaded by the rope, let us say. Then, jagadavyaktamurtina. This again is avyaktamurti. This is the consciousness is something which is that avyaktamurti. It is appearing as all this whole thing. Then matstani sarvabhutani. That is, all these things are in me. That is one meaning. All these things are appearing in me. That is what we have to take. All these things are appearing in me. Matstani sarvabhutani. Nacha aham teshvavasthitaha. I am not existing in them in the real sense. I am not existing in them. they are in me, I am not in them. They are appearing in me, but I am not in them. Chandrasekhar Bharati Swami gives one good example. Suppose we say, this room, the whole room is filled with smoke, let us say. And for the entire smoke, what is the Aadhara? The Aadhara is the room. Aadhara means the support. Aadharam, the support for the whole, the entire smoke is this room. But, say the room is the Aadhara for the smoke. So that sort of meaning may come when he says, Maya Tatamidam Sarvam. That means Jagat will be the Aadhara for Brahma. That meaning can be taken. So to avoid that sort of understanding, he says, what does he say? Nachaham Teshvavasthitaha. I am not in them. He is very, very clearly saying that I am not in them. Is it clear? So that room and smoke, that is the example given by Chandrasekhar Bharati Swami. So when I say that, again I'll repeat, when I say that this room is filled with smoke, then the understanding is that this room is the Aadhara for the smoke. And similarly, when Brahma says, Maya Tatamidam Sarvam, this entire room is filled by me, or this entire Jagat is filled by me, Jagat becomes the Aadhara for Brahman. Jagat is not the Aadhara. Brahman is the Aadhara, Brahman is the Adhishthanam for Jagat. So that is the reason why he says, Nacha Aham Teshvavasthitaha. And in the very next line he says, Nacha Mastani Bhutani. Then Nachamastani Bhutani Ityevameva Vyachiklupat. So I will read the shloka. Ishvaro Vastu Tatvagnyo Nacha Aham Teshvavasthitaha Nachamastani Bhutani Ityevameva Vyachiklupat. So he says, Nacha Mastani Bhutani Ityevam Vyachiklupat. Vyachiklupat means he expressed so. He expressed the verb. What exactly is the verb? I have to check up. Vyachi klapat. So I have to check up the verb. So anyway, Ishvaraha Vastu Tatvagnyaha. Vastu Tatvagnyaha means, Vastu means what? That which really exists. Tatva. Tatva means the reality. Reality of what exists and what does not exist. So that is Vastu Tatvagnya is the person who knows whether what really exists and what really does not exist. So that is what it means. So Ishvara, we are now referring to Lord Krishna there in Gita. He says, Nacha Aham Teshvavasthitaha. That game, same example of room and smoke. Jagat is not the Aadharam. The point is, Jagat is not the Aadharam for Brahman. Brahman is the substratum in which Jagat is appearing. Then Nachamastani Bhutani Ityevameva Vyachiklupat. That is the higher view. So while reading that Gita, we have seen that Mastani Sarvabhutani is a lower level of understanding, isn't it? God pervades everything, He is there in every being, etc., etc. That is for a lower level of understanding. But the higher level of understanding is, in reality, if you really want to tell the truth, Nachamastani Bhutani, in reality, they are just appearances, they are just manifestations. It is a phenomena. Jagat is a phenomena. So, Nachamastani Ityevameva Vyachiklupat. Vyachiklupat means he expressed, he made it very clear. Then the next point is, again he says, if something were to be true, it has to be true, it has to be seen at all times, in all avasthas. So, that is what is the next shloka. Yadi Satyam Bhaved Vishvam Shushuktava Upalabhyatam Yan nopalabhyate kinchit ato sat swapnavan mrusha ato sat swapnavan mrusha. Then yadi satyam bhaved vishvam. If the vishvam were to be satyam, satyam is something which is existing in all states. Satyam is something which is trikalabhadhyam, which should always appear. If that satyam were to be true, then sushuptav upalabhyatam, let it be seen in sushupti. So the point, the logic here, what Chandrasekhar Bharati Swami explains is, first point is, Sati is something which should be there in all avasthas. But in waking state, there is no dream. Suppose in waking state, we are in the waking state. In this waking state, there is no dream. Suppose you say somebody is daydreaming, that's a different thing. That daydreaming we are not considering. So we are considering the dream world. The dream world is not there. So that is why we say that a dream is something which is unreal, isn't it? So similarly, in Sushupti, world is not seen, so obviously on the same analogy, on the same logic, the world cannot be real. The world is tentatively real, that's all. So that is what he says, yadi satyam bhaved vishvam sushuptau upalabhyatam. Then yen nopalabhyate kinchit, yat means yasmat, because kinchit na upalabhyate, because nothing is seen or nothing is noticed in that sushupti avastha. Then ataha asat swapnavan murusha, tat ato asat. So that is the reason why it is unreal. Unreal means not absolutely unreal. We are not talking about absolute unreality. We are talking about that relative unreality, that is sadasadhyam anirvachaniyam. Tato asat mithya. Then swapnavat mrusha. It is some sort of phenomenal existence. It is some sort of mrusha. That is, Chandrasekhar Bharati says, drushta nashta swarupam. That it is seen, but it is negated. Drushta nashta. Drushta is seen. Nashta, it is negated. Drushta nashta swarupam. So, Mrusha is, it is not extremely unreal like Shashavishanam. So, that is what we have to remember. Then, Shankaracharya goes on to say like that, Atah pruthangnasti jagat paratmanah pruthak pratitistu mrusha gunahivat aropitasyasti kimarthavatta adhishthanamabhati tatha brahmena. Atah, therefore, पृथक नास्ति जगत परात्मनः जगत दिस यूनिवर्स परात्मनः पृथक नास्ति परात्मनः इज पंचमी विभक्ति परात्मा परात्मा इज द वर्ड परात्मनः इज पंचमी विभक्ति अपार्ट फ्रॉम परात्मा परात्मनः मींस अपार्ट फ्रॉम परात्मा जगत पृथक नास्ति दिस जगत डज नॉट हैव एन इंडिपेंडेंट एग्जिस्टेंस दैट इज वी आर ऑल टॉकिंग ओनली अबाउट द इंडिपेंडेंट एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ द जगत. The basic point is about the independent existence of the jagat apart from Brahma. It is not so. So that is what it is. Then pruthak pratitistu. This pratiti means appearance. Pruthak pratitistu. Mrusha guna ahivat. Mrusha means this is unreal. Guna ahivat. Guna is rope. There is another word. The meaning for guna is rope. For that word guna, you know satya, sattva, rajas, tamo, guna, that is one meaning. Guna also means the bow string. If you take a bow, there is what is called a bow string. So that bow string also is called guna. And then guna also means an ordinary rope. So guna ahivat. Ahi means snake. Guna ahi. Ahi tundilaha, we say ahi. Ahi means snake. Guna ahi. Guna ahi means rope snake. That's all. Gunahivat, it is mere pratiti, it is just an appearance, it is just a manifestation. Then, aropitasyasti kim arthavatta, aropitasya, for something which has been attributed, for something which has been, say, superimposed or attributed, kim arthavatta, what reality is there? What reality, what sort of reality is there? You see, we are talking about what we have called the degree of reality of things. So, Brahman alone is absolutely real. All others are tentatively real. What we call as ontology, that is the degree of reality of things. When we talk about that, we only say that Brahman alone is real and all other things are apparent appearances and tentatively real. That's all. Then, adhishthanam abhati tatha brahmena. Kimarthavatta, what reality is there? And adhishthanam, that adhishthanam, that whatever is that base, whatever is the support, whatever is the substratum, that is something which shines. Abhati. Bhati, abhati, both are one and the same. Bhati means shines. A is only an upasarga. Abhati. Tatha brahmena. By virtue of this ignorance, by virtue of this moha, it is seen. It is seen as something different. Then bhrantasya yadyad Brahmatah pratitam brahmaiva tattad rajatam hishukti. I think we have read about roughly 10 shlokas. Yeah. Huh? Yes. Okay, we will read this shloka and stop. Bhrantasya yadyad brahmatah pratitam brahmaiva tattad rajatam hishukti. Idam taya brahma sadeva rupyate tvaropitam brahmani nama matram. Again, we are referring to that Vacharambhana Shruti. So, that Chandrasekhar Bharati Swami also has mentioned that Vacharambhana Shruti again. Bhrantasya. Bhrantaha means somebody who is deluded. Bhranti is delusion. Bhrantaha is somebody who is deluded. Bhrantaha, Brahma is delusion. Bhrantaha, for Bhranta, Bhrantasya means for a deluded person. Yad yad Bhramataha pratitam. Whatever is seen because of Brahma. Bhramataha is again in Panchami Vibhakti. Bhramataha pratitam. Whatever is appearing because of that Brahma, because of that delusion, all that is Brahmaiva. Brahmaiva tattat, all that. Tattat is all that. Whatever, yad yad tattat, whatever, all that. Yad yad means whatever is seen, all that is rajatam, all that is Brahmaiva. Rajatam hi shuktihi. Then whatever is seen as rajatam is nothing, it is not rajatam but shukti only. Rajata, you know, rajata is silver and shukti is that white metal or white nacre or whatever it is. It is called nacre. That is somewhat like a white shukti. It is not even white metal. It is shukti, is that what is recovered from the seas. That shukti. Then idam taya Brahma, likewise, what do we see? Idam taya means appearing as this objectified world. Idam is that objectified world. Idam taya, it is seen as the objectified world. Brahma sadeva rupyate, that sadeva Brahma, sat Brahma eva. Sadeva Brahma means sat Brahma eva. That Brahma, whose nature is of the nature of sat, that alone is rupyate. Rupyate means it is known, it is seen, it is perceived. That Brahman alone is perceived as idam taya. Then tvaropitam, what is tvaropitam? Tu aropitam. Tu aropitam tu. So we have to take it as aropitam tu. This whatever has been attributed, aropitam tu brahmani nama matram. Whatever is aropitam, whatever is attributed in that Brahma is nama matram. What is that? Vacharambhanam vikaro namadheyam. Instead of namadheyam, he says nama matram. So that is merely name. So we will stop here and we will continue. In fact, the next few shlokas also go in the same vein. Again, in the same nature of Brahman, he carries on. Harihi Om Tat Sat.